the 90s, we realized that to be successful, we needed to domesticate the black tiger prawn. In other words, breed them in captivity. So we asked CSIRO to give us a hand. And basically what they've come and helped us with is the health screening of them, and now, as we've got to the end of the whole road, the genetics. The relationship with CSIRO has been very beneficial to the whole industry. Every year, our prawns are improving. We've got a prawn that we consider to be as good as anyone in the world. Not only do they grow faster and eat less food and obviously create a far better economic return for us, it's a matter of getting your animals into the ponds when you require them. And that's priceless.
It's been great to watch the Alzheimer's work come together over the last couple of years. We asked CSIRO to put their world's best clinical trial together with our imaging agent, flutametamol, and our diagnostic imaging machine, so we would image a sample of people in Australia and try and demonstrate that this imaging agent does pick up the early onset signs of Alzheimer's disease. And we're now at that exciting stage where we're imaging real patients and, you know, building a database that's going to help in future to detect Alzheimer's 10, 20 years earlier than is possible at the moment. Allowing patients to be alert to the possibility to change the lifestyle, to change what they're doing, and hopefully prevent full onset of Alzheimer's disease.
When I was first employed at Middle Harbour School, my role was to lift the profile of science in the school. We asked CSIRO to support us and help us as best they can. We were offered the opportunity to be part of the Scientist in Schools program, and it appealed to me because we'd be able to use a real scientist in our programs. As an Australian community, we are very lucky to have an organisation like CSIRO using their knowledge and financial input into the school system, into education. We are able to ensure that the students of today are the scientists and engineers of tomorrow.
We looked around the world, looked at what all the global ISPs were doing, and the focus was heavily targeted towards power management and energy management in the home and small businesses. There really wasn't an all-in-one solution. So we asked CSIRO to assist us in developing a platform that our end users could use to manage and monitor their energy usage. So the software that resides in Buddy communicates with the peripheral devices around the home, such as wall plugs, washing machines, air conditioners. We predict they could probably save around about $200 to $400 a year off their energy bill without really trying, which is a significant saving.
Well, CSIRO has, over the last sort of 5 to 10 years, has placed a lot of importance on creating partnerships with Aboriginal people. At Nailsmer, based in Darwin, the group was looking at establishing methodologies for this carbon farming initiative, and one of them was fire abatement. And we asked CSIRO to assist the Aboriginal traditional owners to work towards proving up the methodology. Nowadays, it's very important that Aboriginal people in Northern Australia, with the assistance of Nailsmer, be able to capture the traditional science and knowledge that's embedded in the Aboriginal community. The West Arnhem Land project has demonstrated how that relationship can be formed and that very viable enterprises can be created.
Our core business has always been in food manufacture, primarily muesli-based breakfast cereals, and more recently we've been making muesli bars. We'd heard about a new grain that CSIRO had developed over many years called Barley Max. Well, it has got the highest fibre of any grain that's on the market, and it has a very particular type of fibre, and that's called resistant starch. We asked CSIRO to more or less authenticate the type of products that we were making in terms of the health that we're offering our consumers, and they've been able to do that. We're a stronger business now, and I have had a very good overall relationship with CSIRO and very happy to have worked with them, and hopefully we'll continue to work very successfully with them into the future.